Lovely, welcome to this new Chinky's transmission, this time with the 29 Chinky. And this is very special because this Chinky is also in my hologenetic profile in a very prominent position, and I have contemplated it a lot. And so it's really a topic that I noticed that's deeply into my life. And so stay tuned, this will be really, really special today. So this Chinky is all about, commit yourself to life in a sense, and commit yourself to the tasks, to the actions, to the intentions, to everything that you do. The shadow is half-heartedness. That's what's happened when you don't commit to life. The gift is commitment, and the city is devotion. The programming partner is the 30 Chinky, which I also put here. It's in the shadow desire, so half-heartedness and desire, they kind of reinforce each other. The same goes to the gift level. Gift is at the 30 Chinky lightness, so lightness and commitment goes together. So when you commit, it's like always light and easy for you. And at the highest level, it's rapture, so rapture and devotion. Crazy combinations, and I know some aspects of the low and the highs, and it's crazy. So the psychology is the second chakra, which is the sacral chakra, which is all about emotions, about the inner child, about the female aspect, especially in the emotional life. So the ring here, the Kodun ring, is also the ring of union, like in the last video with the forgiveness, with the fourth Chinky. So there's the fourth Chinky inside, the seventh, which is in the city, the Virtu. Then there is the 29, which we have today, and the 59, which is transparency. And this is also a lot about relationships, about human relationships. So the 29 is also about human relationships. And when I'm, for example, not able to commit myself to relationships, they just don't work. That's just how it is for me in my life. And so let's go right into the abyssal, kind of. It's the shadow. It's the life half lived. What's written in the book? I always read like some extracts from the book. In the book, it's written the 29 shadow of half-heartedness in combination with its programming partner, the 30 shadow of desire, creates quite possibly the greatest emotional chaos of any to the shadow pairings. Yeah, kind of. This is a deep and ancient genetic programming within human beings. More than anything, it concerns a basic lack of trust in human desire. That's where also the 30 Chinky comes in play. So desire, as we can learn from the 30s, shadow and its gift of lightness, serves a greater purpose than simply creating emotional confusion. Desire is, when fully embraced, always leads to a beneficial outcome. It is, after all, a pure life energy within us. Something that I'm really contemplating since I joined Chinky's 2.5-3 years ago, and I kind of start to begin more what it means, the desires, and how I'm able to sense them when they happen, when they occur. It's really a special task to do it in my life, and and the point is really in the shadow. It's about either like you overcommit to something, or you are undercommit, or you're not committing. In a sense, you are also not reliable. And I could reflect exactly today, actually, in the morning. I checked which parts I want to read, and I found a really big kind of parts that still sometimes for me are active. And for example, I did not upload some of the videos you can see in my channel. I kind of had all the time the videos, like I put 10 videos up of the weekly pulse of the Chinkies, And then I didn't do like two or three, and then I did one, and then I didn't two or three, and now I start again. So this is also how, yeah, this shows in my life that sometimes I still switch from a commitment and even a devotional state that's especially in this consciousness exploration and in guiding people and myself and everyone towards like this pure and nice consciousness. I see still like sometimes there is like this half-heartedness, and when I fall into like depression states or like a state of where I'm just not happy about something, I'm not able to follow my highest excitements, and I'm just chilling, relaxing, not doing what I'm supposed to do. And this has a lot of issues and problems in my relationships. And yeah, that's some small part about how it's for me within this shadow. So it's also written here, the secret to all commitment lies in the way in which you begin. Very big. It is the energy behind your actions that creates your future, rather than the actions themselves. There is nothing that is worth doing in life unless it is done with absolute commitment. Yeah? Ask yourself how often you do something out of full commitment. I know from myself it's sometimes very harsh and hard and complicated. I make it complicated for myself. Some limiting beliefs in myself tell like, okay, don't overcommit, don't in a way go too much into this devotional state, like not overcommit, because overcommit is like a shadow again, but like to go too much in this just being in the present, in the moment, in the now, and just do what I'm supposed to do, what I need to do, and what I love to do. So it's also written here, without commitment, action lacks power or direction, and above all, it lacks luck. This last comment may sound rather odd, but there exists a universal law then that anything that is done with full commitment carries within it the seed of good fortune. Also very important for business, if you do some business activity, projects, partnerships, if you're married, if you have a relationship, all of there, this is very, very crucial. I know from experience. So, this shadow keeps you a victim of fate rather than being a player in the great play. It keeps you in the sidelines, ensuring that you play roles in life that are dull and monotonous and or else fraught with emotional agony. This chinky is also about human feelings. It's about sex and relating, about failure and success, and desire and expectation. So you can start to begin to notice really how deep this emotional, it's the psychology sacral. So it's the emotional layer, the astral body, and the layer. And it's really, really able to go crazy in life, in your, in my life, in just humans' life. And it shows in the collective humanity right now. There's a lot of changing, and it's related to a lot to this chinky also. And it doesn't matter if you have it in your profile or not, because the desire is, yeah. All human beings have desires, not only human beings, like also the existence itself, like uses desire as a growth, self-growth mechanism to be able to understand and to have the signs if you do something from your heart or not, if you do something that you love or not, if you do something that helps you or not. And it's like a reflection, like an inner reflection, and it helps you a lot. So it all depends how we see desire. And when we change to see desire as we normally do, then a lot changes and we go more into the gift and siddhic and yeah, are an embodiment of what we are truly capable of. So It's also written, the 29 shadow keeps most human beings in repeating patterns because they do not follow things through to their natural endings. True commitment includes the energy to overcome obstacles and adversity. Half-heartedness is about giving up at the first sign of trouble or discomfort, and ultimately all half-heartedness is rooted in deep, unembraced fear. The lesson that comes from the 29 shadow is really simple. If you quit something too soon, you will stay in the same loop. But if you follow experiences through to the end, you will make quantum leaps, both in terms of your good fortune and your fulfillment. Yeah. Yeah. What else there to say? Like, an example for me in my life, I started a lot of projects after I went out from being an employee into the business world, and not a lot of that worked out because at the first sign there was a discomfort or I didn't like it or there was some failure, I capitulated or like I gave up, and then I had to start it again. So there was never this great fortune even until now in the business life. In the investment life it was a bit different. I had commitment, I had a good luck in a sense, and had after I made some failures and had discomfort, I did not give up and kept on going, and I had luck and fortune. So that is a example of how this works and how I reflected this for me, and how you can reflect desire for you in your life. So with half-heartedness, you are constantly concerned about where this path will take you and whether you have made the right decisions in the first place. So we self-doubt a lot here, and we from a mental level also we say like, is this really good? Should I not quit this business because actually I do it now half year and nothing happened, or maybe a year or two and I lost a lot of money, people don't like me anymore, something changed somehow, and should I not quit doing that? And so the this kind of desires and help you also in a sense to make then the right decision and to know when to stop something and when to not stop something. And how to feel this will we discover in The Gift and City, like how you are able to do it more. It's also written here, there's a lot of a lot of parts here in the shadow, and this so crucial chinky. So in this 29 shadow lies the secret of what is generally seen as success. Success in life hangs up on two things, commitment and luck. Commitment actually engenders luck. So when you commit, you are having automatically luck, in a sense. And this shadow also responds to most sexual desire out of fear, which usually manifests as behavior rooted in either guilt or shame. And guilt or shame, they are both the collective patterns we have. And in this sense, half-heartedness means to hide your true feelings or follow them through in secret. Like a lot of people, when they are married, when they're in a relationship, they maybe just have another girlfriend or something like this, and this is an example of how you could do it in secret, or you just hide like some the feelings in another way. And as the old folk sayings saying goes, a life lived in fear a life lived in fear is a life half lived. It is an apt saying for this 29 shadow, which can cause all kinds of emotional trauma for human beings, especially in the domain of relationships and material success. To live half-heartedly means that you never fully embrace and trust your decisions. This shadow makes you constantly worry about your decisions and where they might or might not lead you. Kind of like a little bit similar, like explained then before. It's really about at some point when you start something and there is discomfort because something is not working. Let's keep it simple. For example, you are a salesman and you call 10 people. And when you are into sales, you know, out of 10 people, there might be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, depending on how good you are and how the day is, people that are up for an appointment to talk about, where you can talk about your product. So, and when you have like the first day, for example, of doing that activity and you have never done it before and you are already at discomfort because you know, oh my God, I have to call now people, strangers, in the worst case, even strangers. And then you call them and you are at discomfort and all of the 10 calls do not give an appointment, so you do not have any success at the beginning, then there's even more discomfort and you start to think like, ah, shit, is this really what I'm supposed to do? Shouldn't I do something else? Can't I do something else better? And. Yeah, and that's where like all of that stuff is starting. And yeah, let's go to the repressive nature. Repressive is always the internalized, the more when we put the emotions within and not express it out. So this is overcommitting. So these people are conditioned not only to make commitments but also to keep them no matter what happens. In other words, these people are unable or unwilling to recognize when natural cycles are over. Kind of easy to understand, I guess. These people often become victims of others or they become slaves of large organizations. That means they are not able to change direction even when they get signs that they should do it. And they still keep the same direction. Then the reactive nature is like the projecting one, is unreliable. When the 29 shadow is bled out through the reactive nature, it hides in a deep fear of commitment that is seen by others as a lack of reliability. When one does something without true commitment, then one can rarely follow through an action or cycle with confidence and competence. The usual result is the breaking off of the cycle and the consequent disappointment and sense of failure or shame. These are natures that may say yes to all kinds of things but then react to the pressure by pulling out of their commitment. I have to say, especially like the last, to some extent in some regards, I can see myself in that. Because I gave some promises and I made some mistakes, I made some failures in a sense. For sure, I know there are learnings. Life is all about learnings and the mistakes are to learn. So, however, like it went this far that, yeah, I make some mistakes that are irreversible. And yeah, sometimes that's how it is in life. And yeah. Let's go to the gift and check what's commitment really about. It's the business of luck. So without this 29 gift and its ability to make crystal clear commitments, life becomes choked and confused, and nowhere is this truer than at the emotional and sexual level. Commitment is akin to trust, which can neither be forced nor willed. It flows like a great river from deep within your being and out into your actions. With commitment, you have no need to think about the future or the goal because the commitment contains the seed of the goal within it. So it's really about that you are more in the now, and commitment is in a sense you commit yourself 100% to yourself, to the intention, to the activity you are doing, and everything else is not available at the moment you commit. For example, now I'm recording this video and I'm getting a lot more comfortable to just focus on doing this transmission and the contemplation for you and doing it also for me for sure. It's like a double, it's helping both of us. So the more I'm able to commit to here and not thinking about, where could there some person come now, or why is like some bird singing or whatever, or there's behind there's somewhere some music singing. So if I'm not letting myself distract and commit to like this, then that means I'm at the point where I'm at my strongest in a way. So those for the 29 gift, the goal is not what is important. What really matters is the commitment to keep following the journey until its end. So you could say that I record now this video is a journey from the beginning to the start. The beginning for myself to make this video was reading like here, and for sure contemplated also for me, making my thoughts out of it, and then getting the camera here, making the video here, then make the video processing, and then uploading it to YouTube, and then publishing it, and all of this until it's live. So this is the process. And a lot of people, if you convert this to a relationship or to a business, they maybe make some reading of a book, and then they make a short contemplation, and they get the camera here, and then discomfort starts, and they tell like, oh my god, I cannot do it anymore, I have to stop this here, it's too uncomfortable, and then this is the unreliability. You tell like maybe to someone, I'm doing this and that, and then you just skip it and you you just go away and you don't do it. So to your entire to live your entire life with this profound level of commitment means to make every decision with the same commitment, from the way you have sex to the way you wash the dishes. As this is really interesting, because it means the commitment should not change whether you do dishes or you have sexual activities or you have your passion, you do jogging, you play tennis, you just relax, you meditate, you talk to people, you listen to people, you share some topics, and everywhere you should have that commitment to be at that activity and to do it. So as an integral part of the Camille family known as the Ring of Union, the 29 gift shares a common theme with the 4, 7 and 59 chi keys. This codon ring is currently undergoing a great deal of spontaneous mutation in our DNA and is directly responsible for a huge shift in the way in which we humans relate, particularly through our sexuality and gender. So if we see it like this, the fourth chinky, I did this last week, it's the gift of understanding. Then the seventh chinky is the gift of guidance, and the 59th chinky is the gift of, what's the gift? That's a good question. I know the shadow and the city. City is transparency, and shadow is dishonesty, and the gift is intimacy. Intimacy, here we go. So many chinkies. So it's about intimacy. So intimacy, then also the commitment, then also the guidance, and also the understanding. They go together in this union. Like, it's kind of like when you commit yourself, you have an understanding at a body physical level what you're doing, and then also you have the guidance, the inner guidance and the outer guidance, you just do it, and at the same time you have the intimacy with yourself, with your own system. So that's how you can also see and contemplate the codon rings and the chinkies in general, which is there's unlimited possibilities to do it. So the only real commitment is commitment to your own inner guidance in the now. What I kind of like just told. Finding this guidance is dependent on your surrendering to life force, within you, which involves utter trust in life's natural cycles of commitment. So it's also about trust and surrendering to, yeah, trust just that the commitment you are doing is the right move at the time you are doing it, and this is the needed move that will bring you forward to more fortune, abundance, freedom, peace, and everything there is. So true commitment is an energetic dynamic felt within your whole being rather than a social requirement. Many people view commitment through morality. You see this particularly in human relationships where commitment is generally enforced by social pressure. If, for example, a relationship breaks up or a marriage ends in divorce, it is still often thought of as failure. Through a true commitment is not mortalistic. It lasts as long as it lasts. When the cycle is over, it is over, and both parties feel this at the same time. good question what I should tell about this, because it's kind of for me that I'm kind of going through a similar process than what was just written here. And I have to say that it's not always worked out as it was supposed to work out for me. And yeah, it's like not emotionally easily all the time. I don't want to have any excuses, but like at the same time, it was kind of like also a reason I did not regularly do the videos. I just didn't feel to make them because I wanted to pour my whole heart into the videos when I'm doing them, and not doing them when I'm in emotional turbulences and feeling sad or even a bit in a depressed mode. So yeah, I can relate to that. When you really commit, then it really feels like it's a finish line. However, it sometimes really happens that you go back to the shadow and reconsider what actions and what kind of decisions you made. I also had this, and it means like you say like, ah, maybe there is still some possibility that it's happening the other way around. And then you are again like in the shadow of, yeah, desire and what desire you want, and like the half-heartedness, you just don't know what you want. There's A, B, and then there's maybe C, D, and more options even starting. And then, yeah, there's a lot of turbulences. Turbulences is the 36th chinky. Turbulences, then humanity and compassion, also in my profile actually. So people with this, people with the 29 gift in their hologenetic profile can be exceedingly lucky people. Their clear, committed decisions create conditions for their own good. These people cannot afford to be led by others. They cannot listen to teachers, gurus, oracles, or systems. Yes and no. I'm not sure if this is Richard Rudd. I'm not sure if this is 100% correct. No kidding. For sure, you should listen to everyone in a way. However, you should probably not in a way follow everyone. Like, you should listen and then commit from your full heart if this is some truth for you, or and if it has some value or not. Maybe it's meant like this, but like that's how I see it. So I love to talk with teachers. Everyone is a teacher to me. Even people that are really into the shadows are the, even they are the greatest teachers, because I understand what the shadow mean when I'm in contact with them. So with the 29 gift, the clear decision is felt as a quiet and powerful warmth that courses through your whole being. I had this, I will put this at the top here somewhere, the fourth transmission, the fourth chinky, which I did last time. I also talked about that you have to feel through your whole body whether something is true for you or makes sense and makes you happy. And it has to resonate through the whole being and the whole body, just in the whole system. That is when your heart is open, not when you feel it just in the head, at the heart, somewhere else. Because when you just feel it at one point, at the heart or somewhere else, that actually means that there's energy stuck. That doesn't mean that you are talking or acting out of the heart. That means the energy is stuck there. So if you feel something only at one point, and there's the focus that is not, yeah, it's not really hard to opening actually. There's a lot of misconception and misthoughts, and we are geniuses. Our belief system, the limitings, negative, whatever, they are geniuses in convincing us that when, for example, it makes so sense, right? Our heart is like here, and then we feel something at our heart. And then our mental comes in and say like, oh, look, your heart is open. Your heart is open. You don't have to do anything anymore. It's open already. And then we believe it in the worst case. And then you're like, okay, I have an open heart already. What is there else to open? And then we are stubborn to grow. And we just die and stagnate. And we do this our whole lives. We don't even go out of like... that comfort zone. And you notice I'm getting a little bit different today in this video, because it's like, it's just crazy, this chinky. It is at this stage that you begin to understand that to commit is also to surrender, rather than expending a huge effort to maintain your commitment. You simply surrender yourself to it. Sometimes if you feel a lack of commitment, it is because you need to surrender even more deeply into your process. Exactly the example what I told now, just explained differently. Just because you feel something at your heart does not mean that you're fully heart open. Within business, there are many cycles that begin and begin again. Financial success cannot be measured by a single cycle, but by continued commitment and certainty in your decision making. For example, sometimes when you stay committed to a direction that seems to be unsuccessful, it opens into opportunities that later become successful. You cannot think your way through life. You can only align your inner direction, truly trust in it, and come what may, and allow nature to do the rest. That's the purpose, that's the pure magic of the 29 gift. Yeah. Yeah, what else? That was a little bit paradoxical. You see that I have also no idea what to tell. So thank you very much, Richard Rudd. You you write good parts here in this book, I have to say. I really love it. 29 city devotion. Let's go to the crazy part. Tantric contagion. When the gift of commitment takes on a universal level of functioning, it becomes transmuted into the city of devotion. Out of this consciousness, all the great paths known in the East as Bhakti Yoga have arisen. Bhakti Yoga refers to the path of devotion or the path of the heart. Devotional paths are all paths of self-surrender in which you completely lose your own sense of self in another. The other can be a mission, as in the case of Mother Teresa's devotion to the poor, or the other can be an ideal or a symbol such as a god or a guru. The path of devotion is far removed from society. Devotion is commitment gone crazy. It is mad in the sense that you have to leave the order of your mind to enter into the wildness of your heart. There is no mind anymore. And it's like... there is no mind in the sense of that there is some separation. It's just a union, and that's, we are in the cordon ring of union. And when you are in this siddhic state, you are really in union with nature, in union with humanity, with universe, with everything, with all that is. And there is really a union, and that's why it's a bit mad, because it's not what humans normal experience. At a certain stage in this process, you cannot help but become a devotee of some higher cause or being, and yet still the process goes on. It requires you to surrender your very identity to what appears to be an outside being or symbol. appears. Very important word here. It appears that it's outside. However, all it's inside. Because everything that's outside is also inside, and everything that's inside is also outside. So it's really a pure reflection. And yeah. When the quantum leap from the 29 gift into the city occurs, an extraordinary thing happens. All the love that has been poured into the object of devotion suddenly begins pouring back into the devoted one from everything in their universe. So it's really like you have, because devotion and rapture, rapture is from the 30 Chinki, they align together. They activate each other strongly. So when you devote yourself to something, you also are in this rapture state and you feel the rapture state, and it's just feeling mind-blowing, and it's just feeling like not a daily experience like normal humans have. I can tell from experience that I had some experiences that were so much far greater than any sexual experience I could ever imagine of having. Then it's kind of like giving a little bit the desire away of sexual desire, because I know there are different kind of experiences, ecstatic experiences that are really insane. And it doesn't mean that we should not have no sexual ambition in a way, not ambition, but intimacy in a way, which is we are humans, human beings, and it's nice to have intimacy. I also love to have it. It's great. It's great to be with another human being that you like and love, and you have the intimacy. However, that doesn't mean that there are like experiences that where you sense something that is more in a co on a collective level, not on even a human level. You cannot even grasp it like that much. So the programming partner is the city, and these two words, devotion and rapture, are inseparable. These people are literally seized by love. The aura of such a being is so soft that it can draw in almost anyone as a devotee. When meeting this frequency in flesh, it is nearly impossible to say no to such a being. I love this, and I hate what Richard wrote right here. If you watch this, Richard, I love and hate it at the same time. I love it because it's the truth, and I hate it because there is some part written like that you can make anyone a devotee in a way. You that watches this, you probably know there are a lot of people, a lot of masters, spiritual masters, teachers in India, in everywhere in the world, and there is always the danger that people are devotee and they follow and they worship someone, and that means exactly at the same time that they are still victims and they are not the creator and co-creators themselves, because they always need some other purple they always need some other people. So yeah, I hate and love that part of the this is the first transmission where I criticize Richard. Nah, kidding. I mean, all of the book is over 10 years, so it's awesome what's written there. However, yeah, today somehow it spontaneously happened. What can you do when it happens? So when the life currents begin to move through the chambers of your chest and heart, the devotional energy is activated. This is the essence of Tantra, the spontaneous surrender of your being to its higher evolution. So it's really about Tantra also, and that it's like the opening of the heart and keeping it open. And that is where like this crazy emotional, not emotional, energetic feelings, experiences, sensitivity, yeah, experiences that go beyond your five senses are able to exist, and you are able to experience them. So as you may recall, the ancient Chinese refer to this archetype as the abysmal. In the shadow, I did not talk there about it. There is no greater symbol for diving into the abyss than that of living your life entirely from your heart. Yeah, it's all about the heart. However, between the realm of the gifts and the realm of the city lies the great abyss. It is this abyss that brings an end to worship. The great challenge for the devotee is to allow him or herself to be annihilated and take the great leap into full embodiment. I take back the criticism because here it's kind of written, okay, when you reach a level, then you are feeling like the creator, you embody the creator, and you are into the, yeah, into your siddhic state. So, yeah, it's very subtle together in a sense. The 29th city of devotion is an absolutely contagious city. Wherever it goes, it inspires devotion in others. This electrical, almost sexual aura creates considerable waves when it appears in the world. These are masters who care nothing for morality or taboos. They are only interested in one thing, surrender into the heart. And that's what Chinki is, in the sense, for me, all about, to surrender to the heart. To put the heart over the mind and let the mind be there to do the things, the activities that it's meant to be there for, which is play, which is analyzing some parts. And it's not there for making decisions, it's not making there for having more happiness in your life, it's not even there to create more wealth and abundance and freedom in your life. All of that is the heart's activity, and your heart is able to make it. Even the heart is like kind of, I don't know, centered somewhere here. In the sense, in a city perspective, it's not here, it's everywhere. It's kind of in the whole system. This is the city of saying yes to life. It gives itself to absolutely anything or anyone that comes its way. The message of the 29th city is exactly this: trust your heart above all else and never worry about the consequences. To be devoted means to lie forever in the lap of the divine. Lie, not like lying, like you lie to someone. It's like lying down. I hope they are both the same written. So to be devoted means to lie forever in the lap of the divine. That's it about the transmission today. Thank you very much. I want to end this with some spontaneous feeling of this devotional state for everyone that is kind of still like here now in the video. So there might be some parts of the book or might be some parts where you resonated just now in this video. So just go back to this part where you like just kind of sink yourself back and go back in the past to like 10 minutes ago or 20, where this part is where you resonated in this video with, and go into the sensation. And it has to be really from the whole body. And then when like this feeling comes from the whole body and it's there, you just focus on this feeling. And you can notice that it's getting stronger through your whole system. And yeah, that's a small mini exercise today. So it's all about focus, commitment and love. And thank you very much for watching this video. Thumbs up and subscribe to this channel if you have not yet. There will be a lot of more great videos coming in the future, in the now, in the past, whatever, when you watch it. And have a great day, your Dominic, and see you soon. Bye bye.